In this video, we're going to start the study of linearization. So far, we've talked a lot about linear differential equations, systems, and systems of linear difference equations. Now we're going to start to talk about nonlinear equations and how we can approximate them with linear equations. Now, we're going to start off with things in just one variable. We'll move up to things with vectors and matrices in a subsequent video. So let's suppose we have a differential equation, dx dt is x minus x squared. This is called the logistic equation. So you'll notice that if x starts off at 0, that if x is 0, then the derivative is 0, and x of t being 0 for all time is a perfectly good solution. So we call 0 a fixed point. Any value that if you start there, you stay there forever, is called a fixed point. So if we start exactly at 0, we forever stay at 0. But what if we start only kind of close to 0? What if we start at x equals 0.0001, for example? What happens then? Well, we know that our derivative is x minus x squared. And x minus, as long as x is small, x minus x squared is approximated by x. You know, 0.001 squared is much, much, much smaller than 0.001. So we just ignore the quadratic term to get a pretty good approximation. And of course, we know what the solutions are to dx dt equals x. The solution is e to the t times whatever value we started with. So if you start off with 0.001, you wind up with 0.001 e to the t for a while. And this keeps growing and growing and growing. And eventually grows big enough that x squared is too big to be ignored. But for a while, it goes as e to the t. So it runs away until you're no longer in the neighborhood of 0, and then all bets are off. Now, in this case, the approximate equation, dx dt equals x, is called the linearization of the exact equation. This is the true equation. This is the linearization. The linearization is an approximation. We say we do this near x equals 0. But x equals 0 isn't the only fixed point. If you start off with x being 1, then 1 minus 1 squared is 0. And if x starts off as 1, then x equals 1 is a solution that goes for all time. So 1 is also a fixed point. 0 is a fixed point, and 1 is a fixed point. And if we start off with x close to 1, then we have to approximate x minus x squared near 1. And this is where Taylor series helps us. Actually, in this case, it's a polynomial. We could do it without Taylor series. But in general, you do a Taylor expansion. F of 1 plus f prime of 1 times x minus 1 plus something times x minus 1 squared plus something times x minus 1 cubed plus something times x minus 1 to the fourth, and so on. And we're just going to stick with the first term. In this case, f of 1 is 0. So f of x was x minus x squared. F of 1 is 0. And f prime of 1, well, let's see, 1 minus 2x, that's negative 1. And so we get minus x minus 1. So this function near x equals 1 can be approximated as negative x minus 1. And so our procedure is we let a new variable, I'm going to call it y, be x minus 1. Then the derivative of y is just the same as the derivative of x because the only difference is a constant. The derivative of f of x is f of x, which is approximately negative x minus 1, which is negative y. So our linearized equations, if we accept this approximation that f of x is roughly minus x minus 1, says the derivative of y is minus y. We know what the solution to that is. Y at t is e to the minus t times y of 0. And as long as y of 0 was very small, y of t is even smaller. If the approximation was good to begin with, over time it gets better and better and better and better. So, and what is x of t? Well, it's 1 plus y of t. So it's 1 plus e to the minus t times stuff. So over time, y of t gets closer and closer and closer to 0. X of t gets closer and closer and closer to 1. Now, here's a picture of how things behave. I'm drawing x as a function of time. It starts off close to 0 and grows proportional to e to the t. But eventually, it gets big enough that you can no longer approximate it as e to the t. E to the t would go screaming off upwards here. and it levels out, and it starts approaching 1, and the difference between x and 1 shrinks exponentially. The difference goes as e to the minus t. Another way to describe it is with a flow diagram like this. What I've drawn is a possible values of x. Here this is the t-axis, this is the x-axis. And here's the curve for y equals the curve for f of x equals x minus x squared. So between 0 and 1, x minus x squared is positive. That means the derivative of x is positive. We're being driven to the right. When x is less than 0, or when x is bigger than 1, we're being driven to the left because x minus x squared is negative. So you see that if you start off at 0, you stay at 0. If you start off to the right of 0, you get pushed to the right harder, 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 less, 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 until finally you approach 1. If you start off bigger than 1, you get pushed down until you approach 1. And if you start off less than 0, you get pushed to the left really hard. Okay? We call 0 an unstable fixed point because if you start near 0, you run away. We call 1 a stable fixed point because if you start near 1, you run towards 1. And by the way, you can solve the equation exactly. The exact solution goes as a constant times e to the t over 1 plus that constant e to the t. And you, when e to the t minus c is very, very small, this is approximately an exponential. When e to the t minus c is very big, you can rewrite it as 1 minus 1 over this, in which case it's approximate goes as e to the minus t. Okay, so our qualitative understanding is confirmed by the exact formula. Most nonlinear equations you can't find an exact formula. This one you can. So here's how you do things in general. Somebody gives you dx dt as a function of x, and that function of x is something given, x minus x squared or something. Our fixed points are where f of a is 0. If f of a is 0, then x equals a gives f of x equals 0, and you stay at x equals a forever. If instead of starting at x equals a, you start close by, you let y be the difference between x and a, and you approximate your equation, dy dt is dx dt, and you approximate that with a Taylor series. You get f of x, which is f of y plus a, that's f of a plus f prime of a times y, but f of a was 0, so that's f prime of a times y. So now we've got our linearized equation. The derivative of y is this constant, f prime of a, times y. And our solution is y is e to the f prime of a times t times the initial value. If the derivative is positive, this grows. It keeps on growing until you can no longer say that you're close to a and the approximations break down. We call that unstable. If the derivative is negative, it's stable. If the derivative is 0, it's neutral. It's on the borderline between stable and unstable. To figure out whether it grows or shrinks, you need to look at the second derivative and the third derivative and the fourth derivative and so on. So for example, you might look at the equation dx dt equals x cubed minus x. So the first thing we do is we find the fixed points. X cubed minus x is x times x squared minus 1. We factor it, and we see that there are fixed points at 0, 1, and negative 1. The next thing we do is we figure out our derivative. Well, that's easy. The derivative of x cubed minus x is 3x squared minus 1. So at 1, at negative 1, that gives us 3 minus 1, which is 2. That's positive. So near x equals negative 1, y grows like e to the 2t. Near x equals 0, the derivative is negative 1. That's stable. Y goes as e to the minus t. Near 1, f prime of 1 is 2. That's unstable. Things grow like e to the t. And when I say things, I mean y. I mean the displacement from the fixed point. So if you start off close to negative 1, you run away from negative 1 at a rate that is e to the 2t. If you start off close to 0, you run towards 0, like e to the minus t. And if you start off close to 1, you run away from 1 at a rate that is like e to the 2t.